Madrasa, we'd like to know the origin and the history of the Real Madras Handkerchief.
So would I.
రియల్ మద్రాస్ హ్యాండ్కర్చీఫ్ అనేది వాస్తవానికి వేటపాలెం కేంద్రంగా 16వ శతాబ్దం నుంచి ఇక్కడ ఉత్పత్తి అవుతూ ఉన్నది. తర్వాత బ్రిటిష్ వాళ్ళు మనకి మద్రాసులో పోర్టు నుంచి ఎగుమతులు దిగుమతులు చేసుకుంటున్న సందర్భంలో విదేశాలకి బట్ట ఉత్పత్తి ఎక్కడ జరిగేది, మద్రాసు కేంద్రంగా ఎక్స్పోర్టర్స్ వాళ్ళు విదేశాలకు ఎగుమతి చేసేవాళ్ళు. అందుకని ఎక్కడ ఏ దేశానికైతే ఇది ఎగుమతి అవుతుందో అక్కడ ఆ దేశం వాళ్ళు దీన్ని రియల్ మద్రాస్ హ్యాండ్కర్చీఫ్ అని పిలిచేవాళ్ళు.
The city of Chennai, formerly known as Madras, lies on the Coromandel coast of the Bay of Bengal. This was where we started our research.
One of the main reasons we were intrigued by RMHK was due to its obscure history and origin. This fabric was first exported by the Portuguese, but it was the British who played a vital role in the extensive export. Another fact about this fabric that captivated us was its simplistic nature and extensive use across different cultures.
It never was a handkerchief. And that itself is a story, the handkerchief. It was woven in squares. So there were 8 squares which were woven together and bought. So they would use one square as a headscarf, or 4 squares for their undercloth, and 2 squares as a middle cloth. The square itself used to be called rumal. So if you put the word rumal, then they had a very low taxation.
The Kalabari tribes of Nigeria have been using RMHK in their daily and ritual life since the 1600s. They were the dominant importers of the fabric, and most of the changes in design have been influenced by them. Today, most of the RMHK exported is produced on power looms instead of on the authentic handloom. To study its contemporary scenario, we headed to Chirala, a town in the Prakasham district of Andhra Pradesh.
On field, we observed the various processes involved in weaving, the first being the dyeing of the yarns. Initially, it was the natural dyes that enthralled the buyers all over and was an integral part of the fabric. However, today the weavers have moved on to using chemical dyes. The dyed yarns are then dried in bundles on hang stands. Women play an important role in the pre-loom processes of drying and winding the yarns. Today, with the availability of technology, the process has been taken over by machines. Traditionally, RMHK was favored because it was handloom, especially by the Kalabaris, who refused to use power loom imitations of this fabric made by other countries. This is where the word real comes into its nomenclature. However, with the increase of power looms in the past few decades, almost all of this fabric is being woven on power looms and auto looms. This caused ambiguity in our understanding of the real Madras handkerchief. The designs of this fabric were highly influenced by the Kalabaris. The weavers were given all the specifications of the design and the patterns through the exporters, which came all the way from Nigeria.
So the weaving was done only by them, according to our specifications, with the colors we give, and mostly what are the buyers give. Like, most of the buyers are from Africa. So they are particular about certain colors, certain design. And the designs which were going that time, it still moves now. 40 years old design, still in demand.
Which design exactly? The checks?
Checks.
The checks.
Checks.
Okay.
The question of design is something that remained ambiguous to us in the literature as well as on field. The patterns varied from predominantly checks to even plains, bordered and art silk embroidery. However, the checkered pattern is sacred in Africa, as the cross is an important symbol. Not as a Christian symbol, but a tribal symbol, making it the most prevalent design.
I wanted to use technology for what I felt technology should be used for, which is to enhance human value. you know, to make human beings' lives better. We should not become a slave to the technology. Technology should be in service of us.
Today, a lot of powerloom manufactured fabric is being falsely sold as handloom. From our interaction with the weavers and their families, who were very excited to talk about what they do, we learned that their living conditions have been affected by the advent of the power loom. The amount of weaving done by them, as well as their income, have reduced as a result of mass production. Also, weavers are now reluctant to introduce weaving to their children as a way of earning, and actually prefer to get them educated and have jobs in the city.
As of now, the market is dead.
Okay.
Because, see, even the government side, we don't get any facilities. See, right now we are stocking up for almost 2-3 years, no movement at all.
Mm-hmm.
Because of various issues, you know, because Nigeria is oil dependent.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now you know how the oil prices have fallen from about $30 a barrel to now
$6.
At least now it's coming up to 50. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So the whole economy is crashed. There's no spending power there.
ఎప్పుడైతే నైజీరియాలో వచ్చిన సంక్షోభం కావచ్చు, ఆఫ్రికా దేశాల్లో వచ్చిన సంక్షోభాలు, లేదా మన రూపాయి మారకం విలువ తగ్గుదల, వీటన్నిటి ప్రభావం ఇక్కడ చేనేత రంగం మీద పడేది. అప్పుడు ఆకలి చావులు, ఆత్మహత్యలకి చాలామంది బలైపోయినటువంటి సంఘటనలు ఉన్నాయి.
ఓకే, నౌ ఇట్స్ కరెంట్లీ డెడ్, బట్ వెన్ డు యూ ఎక్స్పెక్ట్ ఇట్ టు ద డిమాండ్ టు రైస్ అగైన్?
సీ, ఐ యామ్ ఎక్స్పెక్టింగ్ అనదర్ 1 ఇయర్, 1 1/2 ఇయర్.
ఆఫ్టర్ స్పీకింగ్ టు గవర్నమెంట్ ఆఫీషియల్స్, వీవర్ రిప్రజెంటేటివ్స్ అండ్ డిజైనర్స్, we learned a new perspective about the weaving industry and RMHK than we had before.
A lot of the handloom weavers have to unlearn their craft and go move to a bigger city and work in a factory and just learn to press a button to make things faster and cheaper. So they were not learning new skill sets. What they were doing is unlearning age-old, ancient skills. So to me, the biggest service a human being can give is to be creative and to give his work to someone else and to give satisfaction through work. And to me, industrialization had taken that away completely. Because of industrialization, the focus had gone to quantity and not quality. So it was like, how could we bring the focus back to quality? How could we make the consumer understand value instead of just price? And to me, that was with the human story. Because at the end of the day, as human beings, we're storytellers.
You know, it's neither Real nor Madras nor handkerchief, but it is something special.
Despite the ambiguity surrounding the Royal Madras handkerchief, the dwindling state of handloom, and the end of our on-field research, our journey for a deeper understanding of this fabric continues.
மடம் போட்டே மாறி கொழந்து கபத்தில் மாட்டி புடிச்சு பிஸ்தாஸ் மாக்கிராசோ மாறி ஜமாக்கிராயா பிஸ்தாஸ் மாக்கிராசோ.